What's happening, guys? Well, today I'm doing a little something different, something that I haven't done before, but I think it might be something that you guys would find helpful, those of you Colorado folks. I'm gonna do a spring ride report, and if this works out well, I might do a fall ride report, because what happens in Colorado is you never really know when the snow melts off, so you never really know when you can start riding again. I do like to ride all year round, but you know, when it's bitter cold, I don't ride. You know, I wouldn't say I'm a fair weather rider. I'll ride in the rain, I'll ride in the cold, but you know, if it's in the negatives, there's no way I'm riding. But let's keep this short. My goal for today is to stop by a bunch of key locations that I ride down on the Rampart Range area and give you guys a heads up if they're cool to ride yet or not. So let's just do this for number one. I'm sure you guys have seen this. You guys just saw this footage last week, footage of this place. We're going the other way right there. But this is Platte River Road. And I can say, you know, the road's fine. I came down from Rampart. We'll stop by there later and I'll give you a heads up on what's going on up there. But yeah, I mean, a little bit of water, a little bit of mud, nothing bad. I mean, Xena's, you know, just got a couple of mud specks on her, really, nothing horrible. The ride down from, the spruce wood, you know, usually I take the, right-hand fork because it's faster to get down to Platte River Road unless I'm really just taking a tour, then I take the left one, which also goes to Platte River Road, but it's a lot longer. But the right fork has that really steep hill on it that I think you saw in Is the DRZ Powerful Enough For You video. That hill was completely mud covered. It didn't have any snow, no ice, but it was kind of just a throw it in second gear and kind of engine brake down just to be safe. But yeah, I'm not gonna go too much further down here. I might go down to where the broken up sort of pavement starts again. And I'll let you guys know if we find any nasty stuff. Like, here's a little bit of mud. Not bad though. Definitely rideable, easily rideable, even for the newbies. So you guys could head down here. If you encounter mud, just slow down. You want to keep steady throttle. Just keep your weight centered. Don't be trying to make any major adjustments to your steering. And you'll be just fine if it's just a little patch of mud like that. All right, guys. I'm gonna stop for lunch too, so maybe I'll catch you guys at lunch. So I need you guys to do me a favor. I need you to go to Hermit's Facebook page. It's facebook.com/hermitdevlog, all one word. And I need you to rip him a new one. I need you to call him a wuss, call him a pansy, because I said, "Hermit, I'm going out riding on Sunday. Are you free?" And he said, "Yes." I was like, "Okay, I'm gonna go ride down Platte River," and I told him the whole plan about doing the ride report video and whatnot, and he said, "I don't wanna ride the road. It just isn't fun for me, blah, 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 blah," with his hermitness. And I was like, "Dude, it's the first ride of spring, literally." We might be able to ride some dirt roads, I don't know. We gotta go scout it out and see what's rideable now. And he was like, "Nah, I'm just not interested. I'll let you go do the legwork for me, because I'm a giant wussy." So head on over to his Facebook page, give it a like. He's still all right. I'm just giving him a hard time. But yeah, go give him a hard time. Don't be too mean. But yeah, tell him CDS sent you, and CDS says you're a wuss. All right, on to the next spot. Platte River Road from the bottom of Rampart Range to the right-hand side, completely clear to this. This is what I call the almost pavement. Back there around the corner is the old hotel. You guys know where I'm at if you live around here. But anyway, all right, we're gonna go down to Decker's and check out 211, see how that is.
So I found a good spot for lunch. Oh, you guys, you guys wanna see it? I thought you just wanted to look at my pretty face. Here, I'll give you a look around. First of all, got the amazing ham and cheese. Don't forget to pick up the mayo. Mountain Dew and a bag of chips. And I put my little tank on my vaporizer that fills from the top. And you guys that are vaping, the ones that fill from the top don't leak as long as they stay upright while you go up and down elevation. So that thing's working out great. But here, let me give you a little panorama of where I'm at. This is the little state park spot just past Decker's. If you come out Platte River Road and you make a right-hand turn at Decker's and go across the bridge. Go up, I don't know, maybe half a mile, and then it'll be on your left. Be careful, it's kind of a dangerous turn to get in here. The only thing about here is that you have to have a parks pass, a state parks pass, if you want to come in here and eat lunch, because they have picnic tables and bathrooms and whatnot. Or you can pay, but it's like $5, so it's not really worth it if you're just riding through and want to stop and get a picnic table for lunch. There are a couple spots down on Platte River Road that have some, but I really like this spot. I've been coming here for a long time, and I always have a parks pass anyway, so it's well worth it for me to come in here. But I'm gonna finish my lunch, and we will head on to 211 and see how that's going.
Well, all right, here we are out on 211. If you carry on from the state park where I had lunch, maybe about another mile, 211 jets off to the left. It's really easy to miss. You gotta watch out. All these turns for some reason are on blind corners. But you guys will probably recognize this from the footage from the top five video as well. I used a little bit of this. But we are at an elevation of 6,836 feet, and this road goes up and down pretty high. So I was thinking 211 might have some shady spots on it still. But the entrance, where it's pretty much blind corners, I'm about to see a car right here. Yep. Hello. Thank you for not killing me. This is a very the entrance to this road, you really need to be careful. Where I started back there, I was only about a quarter mile off of the pavement. But yeah, until you get up to Cheeseman Reservoir, and I'll show you where that is, you need to be really careful on these blind corners, because this road's really skinny and people do not care. Hopefully this guy will let me go by. But anyway, yeah, I mean, as you can see, there's no snow at 7,000 feet. On up a little bit, there's some more snow. I mean, there's a little bit of snow here, but nothing too bad. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Can't really see any of the high peaks from right here, but we'll get around these corners and I'll show you. But this is just, the entrance to this is absolutely gorgeous. And then it kind of mellows out a little while, and then you go down into this valley, and it is seriously beautiful road. It can be pretty loose and washboardy, so you just need to be a little bit careful on this one. It is it's dirt, but it's pea gravel, so it's kind of like Rampart Range Road in the fact that it can be loose in certain places, so you just need to watch out. But yeah, the riding up here seems to be primo right now. This is, I think I've shown this in a video. It's one of those signs that says no shooting. It's got bullet holes all through it. Another one. But, I don't want to show you guys too much that I've already shown you. I mean, this is in the Cheeseman Reservoir video, and this is also in the, might be in the 211 video. But these are a lot of my stomping grounds, my spots where I go to ride. These are like my go-to places when I'm riding from the house. I mean, it takes me about an hour to get to Rampart Range if I go back roads. I mean, I can go the highway, but with scenic gear down, it's the highway is just like, she maxes out at 80, and like at 65, 70, she's like whining out, you know. So, you know, I just don't want to push her too hard. But yeah, here's what I'll do. I'll pick back up with you guys when I get up a little further, and you can, we'll see how the roads are once I get up to the top. Oh, here it is.
Well, that was easy.
All right, never mind. CDS fail. So if I would have made a right there, that would have taken me on 211. And you just keep going, follow the signs for 211. And 211 will take you all the way out to very near Terriel Reservoir. I'm gonna give you guys a couple of great tips. A lot of you new guys that are gonna be riding this area this year. Number one, the last gas from Denver, if you go the way that I always go, is Sedalia. So you wanna get gas in Sedalia, make sure your tank's full to the brim. Then you need to realize you can only ride half of what your total mileage is that you can get out of a tank. So once you get to half, you gotta turn around and be able to make it back to Sedalia. And that was part of the reason why I ended up with the 4-gallon tank, because I had 120-mile range before, you know, safe, you know, to make sure I got back. And 60 miles, I've already done 43 miles, and I just couldn't go far enough. Like, when you get out here, it's a lot of distance riding, and that's the kind of riding that I like to do, is riding on these fire roads. And you know, go for distance, go to see different places. This year I want to make up some loops to go, you know, all the way to Hermitville. I want to make some loops to go all the way out to Jefferson. I want to go out to 4 Mile. I was talking to Frag and talking about doing some moto camping out at 4 Mile. You know, just all ideas that I'm having right now are awesome. Okay, but back on subject. So last gas is at Sedalia. Deckers does not have gas. So here's what I suggest you do if you're looking for places to ride in this area. And it's not an exact science. Sometimes you just have to get out here and get to know where you're at and what exactly is going on. But if you go on Google Maps and then just type in Deckers, Colorado, that should give you Deckers. And Deckers is like, I don't know, that's one of my landmarks that I use, is Deckers. And from Deckers, you can follow 67 and follow 67 and look for, if you zoom in a little bit, it'll give you dirt roads. And you just keep mapping along until you start seeing forest routes. They're always FS and then a number. So FS 211 is the one that leads up, it's on top of that hill, goes that way. But it goes all down through this valley. And goes all the way out to Terriel, you know, near Jefferson. But yeah, last gas, look for trails, and you'll find a lot of these places are a lot of private property, and there's a lot of roads that you can't ride on technically. Like, this guy obviously has a pass to the gate, but you can go all the way around the reservoir, but they shut it down because of the terrorist crap. And there's actually a really cool spillway over yonder somewhere that you can't even really see from 211 or from here. So hopefully someday I'll know somebody that has a pass to the gate and will take me through and show me. But yeah. So back onto the main point of the video. It looks like all the dirt roads are in pretty dang good shape. I'm impressed. Looks like the snow is up at the higher elevation still. Stopping by a Rampart Range, the gate is still closed. It's all mud up there. It's all still snow covered. So I'm sure all the trails are still all snow and ice. And I won't ride those trails until they're in great shape and people have gone through and figured out where the washouts are. And yeah, they really start to give you a feel of where you can get stuck. Because, you know, they'll put up little warnings and stuff. But anyway, that's a different story. But yeah, if Rampart Ranger Road is closed, I head on down to Platte River Road, go either way, and just start going to the places that I know. And it looks like the places that I know are in good shape. So that's exciting. I'm gonna have to say we may get more snow, but just knowing that there's not feet of snow here is great. So I think, you know, if we get a little bit more snow, you know, it melts off in a couple of days. I have on my WeatherBug app on my phone, I have Deckers plugged in, and I have Woodland Park plugged in. And most of the places that I ride are between the two, or a little bit over this way. This is on the other side of Deckers, not between Deckers and Woodland Park, but yeah, I can get a feel of how the weather is up here, because the weather is drastically different down in Denver. Denver is a high desert, so I mean, they get snow, you know, we'll get a foot of snow, and then it's gone in a couple of days because it just melts off because the sun comes back out. But in some of these places up here, they'll get tons and tons of snow, and it'll be feet. Here, we'll go up to 11 just a little bit. It doesn't melt off for a while. So I had a couple of guys asking me last week about Terrial and 4 Mile and all that. And I said, you know, 4 Mile is probably fine at this point out in Buena Vista. I don't know for sure, obviously, but it's kind of like this. It's very open, so it gets a lot of sun. But Terrial, I have a feeling that most of the trails that go undercover still probably have a lot of snow. And, you know, everything around the Jefferson area, that's all 10,000 feet, you know? So the problem that you have up there is you just get higher in elevation, so it stays colder, and the snow doesn't melt off. So these places that are down a little bit, you know, even though 7,000 feet is pretty high, but they get warmer. Also, this is burn area, so the sun gets right to it, and it has a chance to melt off. Thank you, Washboards. I appreciate you helping my video. So yeah, that's the meat of the video. I just want to say I hope that this is the beginning of riding season. I don't want to officially call it because we still could get slammed with several feet of snow. You know, whatnot. It's a nice parking job right in the middle of the road. But yeah, hopefully this is it, guys. I mean, look at this. I don't want to go too much further because I want to go check one more place. But I mean, so 211 goes all the way down there. You can see that, and then it goes all the way around and it follows this valley all the way down. And just from looking at it right here, I mean, I can see the tops of those mountains are probably 9,000-10,000 feet at least. And you know, I'm sure on the valley floor it's going to be perfectly rideable. Oh yeah, you can see, there it goes. It's all the way over there. I don't know if you guys can see it on the camera. But I think we're looking good, guys. Wah, wah. Rampart Range area is temporarily closed to motorized vehicles due to wet conditions. It's not just wet conditions, which you'll see here in just a moment. It's closed because there's still like a foot of snow. So yeah. Yep. This is the condition of Rampart Range right now. What'd they do, like plow a little section? That's pretty cool. Let's ride up here and see what we can see of the trail that leads from the parking lot to the rest of Rampart Range. So yeah, that's the condition of the trails. Looks like all the quad guys are up here having fun, probably pushing each other because those things aren't four-wheel drive. But yeah, Rampart Range, not yet. Not open yet. So, fire roads, yes. Rampart range, no. Which kind of makes me a liar, because Rampart Range Road is a fire road. But the thing about Rampart Range Road is, and that you guys need to know, is that it's a super popular place. I think I kind of explained that in the top five places for newbies to ride video. Because it's so close to Denver, everybody and their monkey's uncle go there to ride. All right, but seriously, don't be too hard on Hermit. He's kind of sensitive. I don't want him to start crying and not ride with me anymore. Go give his Facebook page a like. And, tell him he's a wuss. He's a wuss. He's definitely a wuss. I mean, look at where I'm at. Hermit, sorry, buddy, you're a wuss.